Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, everyone.
We're back with episode 7 of Walk and Talk.
We're in Wolli Creek, it's a local track.
This morning we woke up to the tragic news of the explosion in Beirut in Lebanon.
And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to alleviate the suffering and the pain of those who have been affected. Our thoughts and prayers for everyone in Lebanon. Inshallah, we're going to go into this walk and talk in Wolli Creek, so join us inshallah. So we're at Girraween Park. This is the start point. It's a paved walking area so you can get to this. And after that becomes like a bit of a walking track and trail. It's a grade 3. So let's go. Australian comedian, the name of Isaac Butterfield, he did a horrendous joke.
I think this joke, perhaps he didn't think it would be so offensive or rude or inconsiderate, but it really, really, really touched a bad spot, you know, with the Muslim community, especially in an event that was so catastrophic.
And that was the 52 people who had died in Christchurch. Now, Isaac has uploaded his response up on YouTube. And he has his justifications on why he said this thing, and he believes it's just a joke and that's not what he believes, and he showed whatever it was, kind of his justification. I don't want to speak about that. I want to touch on something different. You know, it was a distasteful and a horrendous joke. Yet, at the same time, when all of the Muslims right now are chucking a big stink about this, and rightly so, we sometimes are guilty of doing the same thing. How many times have we heard a joke, either by Russell Peters or Jimmy Carr, that's racially motivated, and we think, oh my God, that's a bad joke, but it's funny and you have a laugh about it. But now that it's reversed and it's on the Muslim, you think this is a very hard pill to swallow, and so we don't accept it for ourselves.
100%. And look, even though the comedian tried to justify his responses, we don't necessarily agree with him, but as you said, it's beyond the point. I think what's important to realize is, as the Sheikh mentioned, we should not accept to joke, nor should we accept any jokes that are racially or religiously motivated, right? Especially because they could cause or create harm or hurt for other people.
And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us a way of life. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says in the Quran, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, la yaskhar qawmun min qawmin. He says, O you who believe, let not one group make fun of another group. This is our way of life, whether it's a joke or not. Don't make fun of another group.
But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he teaches us another lesson in the Quran.
That's right, and he says, وَلَا تَسُبُّ الَّذِينَ يَدْعُونَ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ فَيَسُبُّ اللَّهَ عَدْوًا بِغَيْرِ عِلْمٍ.
Do not swear at the people who believe in other than Allah, for it may cause them to swear at Allah without knowledge. So you could be the reason that someone swears at your Lord, at Rabb al-Alameen, because you sparked it, you created it, you know. SubhanAllah, it's a very straightforward lesson. You don't mess with these things.
The take-home message, inshallah, I want this not just to focus on Isaac. You know, his distasteful, very ugly joke. But let's look at and reflect at ourselves. Ask Allah Azza wa Jalla to make us of those who have the best of manners. Amin ya Rabbal Alameen. Let's continue to respect. And that is the end of the track. We're at Torella Reserve, so if you look over here, you can see that there's a park. And Wolli Creek is down there. So what we'll do is, we'll bring up the drone inshallah, we'll show you Wolli Creek. And then after that, we'll punch it back to the car, because it's a one-way track, and we'll meet you guys inshallah at the end. So we tried to bring up the drone right now, but it's saying it has to go into an automatic landing. That's because we're in a no-fly zone. I think it's because we're close to the airport. So Drone's gonna go back down automatically, we can't fly it here. Sorry guys, no drone footage for today, inshallah. Alright, now we're at the end of the track. It took us roughly 20 minutes to complete it one way.
So if you do come on this track, give yourself about an hour, you know, the walk there, the walk back, a bit of time with the family. There was a very nice park at the end that the kids can enjoy.
We'll see you guys inshallah in the next episode. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.